So Kolder counter is an apparatus which is used to count the number of particles and determine the size of those particles that are suspended in an electrolyte. Hi, you're watching PKI Pharmacy. So today in this video we're going to discuss the principle behind Kolder counter and we'll learn a little bit about its construction also. So before going to the principle of Kolder counter, let me show you its construction. So this instrument consists of a container. And inside the container, you can see there is a tube, that is a glass tube. Both the glass tube and the outer container holds the same electrolyte, but there is a difference that the outer container contains not only electrolytic solution, but also particles suspended in it. So the outer container contains electrolytic solution plus suspended particles. Now there is a hole, or better to say an orifice at the bottom of this glass tube. And there are electrodes dipped on both the solutions also. That is, the electrolytic solution inside the glass tube contains the cathode electrode and the outer electrolytic solution contains the anode electrode dipped in it. I think now you can relate that these whole things look like a setup of an electrolytic cell. And yes, it is. But there are some additions, like there is an amplifier and a voltmeter attached to the circuit, which is further connected to pulse processing units. Now let's discuss the principle of Kolder counter. So this instrument counts the number of particles suspended in a solution and also determines their size. Now what happens is that there is a pump attached to the glass tube which pumps a known amount of electrolyte from the outer solution. So a fixed volume of electrolyte moves from the outer solution to the inside of the glass tube through that tiny orifice. And during this movement of electrolyte, the suspended particles also enters through the orifice. But it is constructed so well that only one particle can pass through it at a time. Now when a particle enters the orifice, it displaces its own volume of electrolyte. And this causes a short time change in impedance. Or you can also say a short time change in the resistance across the aperture of this orifice. Due to this change in the resistance, the voltage also changes for a very short period of time as a voltage pulse. Then this voltage pulse is amplified by the amplifier. After that, the pulse heights which are generated are analyzed by analyzer or pulse processing units. In the graphical representation of the voltage pulse, the height of a pulse is proportional to the volume of particle that enters through the orifice. That means, higher the height of the pulse, larger is the size of the particle. And also, each pulse represents a single particle. Now, suppose your graph contains 30 pulses, then the electrolyte also contains 30 particles, which was pumped through that orifice. Oh wait, another thing I need to mention, that this Kolder counter can count 4000 particles per second, and it is useful over the range of particle size between 0.5 micron to 100 micron. So this was all about the principle of Kolder counter. So I hope you like this video. Thanks for watching. Stay healthy. Bye.